Hello students, welcome again in the video lecture presentation series on plant ecology. I am Dr. Deepak Koche, working as professor, Department of Botany, Sri Shivaji College of Arts, Commerce and Science, Akola, Maharashtra. I am welcoming you all in the fourth lecture of plant ecology, entitled as Water, an Ecological Factor. In this lecture, we will see a basic introduction regarding the water, nature of water, properties of water, water cycle, importance of water cycle, and importance of water. So, we all know that water is very essential for everyone, every living organism. It is very essential. In other words, you can say that water is a life support system. Living organism comprises at least 70% of water. It is the only substance present on the earth and in the atmosphere which is present in all three states of as a solid, as liquid, or as a gas at the same time. And about 3/4 of the earth's surface is covered by the oceanic water. As we all know, the polar region is having ice glaciers, but in all forms, in either it may be a solid ice or snow or a liquid, that is we usually call as water, or in gaseous form, in all form it was found to be supporting life on this planet. When you see the nature of water, it is an essential solvent for biological sciences, and chemically it is composed of two molecules of hydrogen and one molecule of oxygen, that is H2O. This H2O bond angle is usually 104.5 degree, okay. And the oxygen is having partial negative charge, while the hydrogen is having the partial positive charge. That's why it is supposed to be a polar molecule. Okay. Coming towards the properties of water, water shows n number of properties, but some major properties I have considered here. This water is having high solvent power. Okay, water is a solvent for a great number of molecules which form the ionized solution in the water, and it may be thus called as the universal solvent. Okay, the water is highly cohesive and adhesive. Okay, because of the hydrogen bonds, water molecule develop strong intermolecular attraction between them, and this is called as the cohesion. Okay, when water forms hydrogen bonds with other substances, the attraction is called as the adhesion. Due to the cohesion and adhesion, the seed swells and germinate. Ascent of sap and capillary movement of the water takes place. So this is very important property of water. Another, it is having high surface tension. The water has high surface tension of any known liquid, and it is the reason only why water rises to unusually high level in narrow capillary tubes. Okay, the next one is the water has high specific heat and high heat of vaporization. Okay, now in this particular property is ensures that slow heating of water, it maintains the constant temperature of living organism and the atmosphere. Again, the next property is water has a high heat of vaporization. Now this high heat of vaporization, it is 540 calorie per gram. This usually causes cooling effect of leaves, and it remove body heat through the sweating and protect organism from the thermal shock. So it is again a useful property of water. Again, next one, water has high heat of fusion. Okay, water requires a loss of lot of heat to freeze. दिस प्रिवेंट्स फ्रीजिंग एंड आइस फॉर्मेशन इन द प्रोटोप्लाज्म ऑफ ए सेल इवन व्हेन एक्सपोज टू ए वेरी वेरी कोल्ड टेम्परेचर, दैट इज फ्रीजिंग टेम्परेचर. ओके, नेक्स्ट प्रॉपर्टी इज वाटर हैज लोअर डेंसिटी और ऑन फ्रीजिंग. We all know that water has maximum density at 4 degree centigrade, but below 4 degree centigrade water becomes less dense and that liquid water floats on surface of the water. Okay, this and it form the underwater film freezing to protect the aquatic life. So it is very essential, this property is very essential to protect the aquatic life. The what again, next property is water has high dielectric constant. This opposes the attraction of the opposite charge of ion. Because of this, water act as a powerful solvent for salts and many non-ionizable organic molecules. So again, the next property is the water can ionize. As we all know, that is the H2O. Okay, it can be split into H positive and OH negative. At 25 degree centigrade, out of 550 million water molecules, only one undergoes ionization. In water, H positive has no stable existence and occurs in the association with another water molecule to form the hydronium ion, that is H3O positive. Next, where water is found? I had already told you that most of the water is in the form of oceanic cover and glaciers. So in the oceans, 96.5% of water is there. Other saline water is around 0.9% and fresh water is only 2.5% that we can use. Okay, because we use only fresh water. Okay, and if you consider this 2.5% available fresh water, of these, 68.7% fresh water is in glaciers and ice caps, 30.1% underground, groundwater, and 1.2% is surface or other fresh water. Now, when we consider 1.2% as 100% water available, of these, ground, ice, and permafrost water is around 69%. Then lakes, in the lakes you found 20.9%, around 30% in lakes. In the atmosphere you found 3%. In the living things you found 0.26%. In the rivers 0.49%. In swamps and marshes 2.6%. And in soil moisture 3.8%. So this is regarding the distribution of water, where you found which type of water. This is I have taken from the US Geological Survey Department presentation. Then next, water cycle. Okay, now this water cycle, we know that there are hundreds of water reservoirs in the form of lakes, in the form of seas, oceans and rivers, streams, lakes, dams, etc. So what exactly is the water cycle? Is wherever is the water in any form, if it is the liquid water, if that particular water is incident sunlight, it get heated and get evaporated, and those evaporated water in the form of water vapors get condensed and then get precipitated. Okay, likewise there is the evaporation from plant surfaces, leaf surfaces, then sublimation of the ice indirectly into the water vapors, it takes place. So whatever water evaporation of sublimation takes place, that forms the clouds. Okay, after condensation it get either transported or it get condensed and it precipitated in the form of rain or snow smelt. So and then that can be again traveled to the different reservoirs. So and some of them it has been utilized by the plants, and some of it has been leaches down to the underground, and mostly it has been blown run down to the major water reservoirs as a lake or a river or oceanic water. So in that you can see that there are number of terms like evaporation is there, that is the it happens when liquid water changes to the gaseous state as a vapor. Solar radiations evaporate water from all water reservoirs and it forms the water vapors. So then transpiration it represents evaporation of water from the plant through stomata and lenticels into the atmosphere. So such terms I had given. Sublimation, that is, it describes how snow and ice changes to water without becoming the liquid. Then again, the transportation, it defines how water moves through the atmosphere in its solid, liquid, and gaseous forms. Then condensation, that is, and precipitation. By condensation, water vapors becomes water droplets via cloud formation and precipitation. And precipitation is the water that falls on the planet Earth. So these things I had, the deposition is there, infiltration is there, surface flow is there, and plant uptake, because only 1% of the water which is on the Earth, it has been taken up by the plants. Okay, now coming towards the importance of water cycle. Now this water cycle is very, very essential because it is the natural phenomenon, and it operates in coordination with the seasonal variation. Okay, water cycle is essential because water precipitation is very important for crop production. Where there is no any ready source of water, if there is no any other source like borewell or any other source is not there, then precipitation should be there. Otherwise, crop cannot be grown to its full bloom. Water cycle distributes water all over the planet. This is again one of the important thing. Water cycle purify water when it gets evaporated. And when it get percolated into deep grounds, it get purified and thus naturally remove the pollutant from water reservoirs. So these are certain importance of the water cycle. Now coming towards the importance of water, everyone know why water is important, but still we will recap it. Water is universal solvent, that's why it is important. Most physiological metabolic processes requires water as a medium for reaction or as a reactant, thus act as a metabolic content. Also, the water on this planet Earth regulates the temperature, overall temperature of the Earth surface, it has been regulating. Water inside the body of the organism regulate the body temperature and keeps the body hydrated. Thus, water is essential for one's life as well as balancing the life on this planet. So this is all about the water as an ecological factor from my side. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you had understand the facts that I had provided to you. And we will meeting soon again for the next video presentation, that is video lecture 5 on light as an ecological factor. Thank you very much.